Hi guys, welcome to Without a Clue Wargaming. James here. I've got another painting tutorial for you today. Tonight I'm going to be painting some of these guys, the grunts. The underestimated, what would you call it? Race of the computer games. I mean, how many times you die by one of these guys in the game? I mean, I can't, hundreds of times I've died on Halo against these guys. But yeah, I'm going to show you how to paint these today. Again, very easy. Very, very easy to do. And you only need a select few colours. So we're going to be painting these guys, which is pretty much exactly the same. All I've done with this model is I've sprayed it with the Chaos Black Primer, and then I've given it a coat of MECHANICUM Standard Grey, and this gives you the base colour for the skin. I usually spray it MECHANICUM Grey, but I've run out of spray paint, so today I did it by brush. And I've even done the base, because obviously the base is going to be this colour as well, so it saves time. But this is where we're going to start. So the colours you're going to need is AVALAND Sunset, Lead Belcher. I think it's XEREUS Purple. I'm using Magic Blue from Valjo Game Air. You can just use one of the blues that's a very similar colour to, I'm not sure what it is, but use one of the blues from Games Workshop. You need AGRAX EARTHSHADE, and then to do the green glow on the plasma pistols, you'll need Sick Green from Vallejo Game Air and ESCORPENA Green from Vallejo Game Air as well. So that's all the colours you need, and let's just crack straight on, shall we? So starting off with AVALAND Sunset. Mine's gone a little bit lumpy, but it doesn't really matter. Because we're not going to, well, I've watered this down, so that's probably my fault that it's gone lumpy. But anyway, right, so all that's going to be yellow on these guys is the two chest plates that you see here. Just blob both, all of them out on all three guys. Nice and simple. Same on both, all three. So that's all the yellow you put on the front, is just the chest plates. Then on the back, we do the main housing for the methane tanks, because these guys don't breathe air, they breathe methane. Some strange reason they're from a planet where the air is thick in methane. That's why in the game, if you shoot the tanks on their back, they explode. So you don't have to be too neat at this stage, because you'll see later on in the video, I cover most of the edges of this are going to be covered in Lead Belcher. So also, I'd like to say that we've been teased with maybe some ODST units dropping soon, which I'm very excited about. So Halo ODST is one of my favorite games ever, yeah, can't wait to have them on the tabletop. But yeah, same again on this guy, just paint AVALAND Sunset. I mean, I'm putting this on quite thick, but put thin layers on. But you'll see towards the end, you just need a bottle of liquid talent, which is AGRAX EARTHSHADE, and that will cover up most of your mistakes. So, same ethos on these guys. Keep it simple. Don't go overcomplicated. And you'll be surprised with the results that you get. So, last one. Nice and simple. So, that's all the yellows done. I'll just touch up a bit on the chest, or I touched it on my finger. And there we go. Right, that's all the yellow completed. Just touch it up a little bit there. And that's it. So, wash your brush out. And then we move on to the lead belcher. Oh, there's one more colour I forgot. Actually going to use this one this time. The steel, or room fang steel. But give your paint a good shake with your metallics, because they always separate. So, with this one, now a lead belcher, all we're going to do is the back bit, just here. I'm going to cover that entire thing with a lead belcher. Don't have to be too neat again. Get right in behind the neck. Do the two little shoulder pads and the bits on the shoulders. And then on the sides, the methane tanks just go up the edge. And then there's like this little metal bit here. So that's, you painted over it with the yellow a minute ago, but just put a dob of lead belcher on that. And then there's the bits down here. So all around their back. Again, I'm not being overly neat, because you'll see why in a bit. So there's another one of these, like rivets almost, on that side. And then last but not least, you've got the actual face mask of his breathing apparatus. So there's a little nodule on either side of the face, and then the bit on the front. And that is one almost done. So do the same again on the other two. Do these quite quick now. Again, I'm not being overly neat. Get the two shoulder pads. You've got the two bits on the sides. And the other side. And around the back. Which is the rest of their breathing apparatus. Breathing apparatus. Oh, I can't speak tonight. It's the second one done. And then, last but not least, the third one. I usually do all these together, so I usually have, like, I build all the bases. That's how I did my first starter set. I built all the bases up, and then I just got a big production line going. And in no time at all, you can have all of the Covenant done. The UNSC are even easier to paint, I feel, but I'll do a tutorial on them another time. If not, it may be already up. Depends on which way round I upload these. So around the, oh, off the camera. Around the back again. Bit on the side. there. So that's that bit so far. This is where we're at. So got all your metals done, all the yellows done. Just gonna wash my brush out again. And then we need XEREUS purple. All this bit is for, give it a good shake, is to do the weapons. So just to do the three pistols, again, you don't have to be overly neat. I've already thinned my paints in all the pots, so I can use all my paint straight out the pot. I usually thin them 50-50. So same again on this one. Oh, rubbing that one off. Get my hands in the way. I'm doing this one real. The only bit I'll cut on this one is the drying time on the wash, just because that will take about 20 minutes. So, but all the rest of it won't take long at all. So that's the weapons painted. So we've got the yellow done, the metals done, and the weapons done. So the only bit you need the blue for, which is magic blue from Vallejo Game Air, is on the grenades. Most of the guys are holding grenades as well, and all you do is, there's a little tiny bit there, just pick that bit out around the front. That's one, and then the second one on this base is just there. And that's the grenades all done. So all I'm going to do now is let this dry, and then we'll give it a coat of wash. So I'll be back in a minute. See you in a bit. All right, welcome back. Right, I didn't show you this on the last tutorial, so I'm going to show you now. So the base is base coated in Mechanicum Standard Grey. I'm then going to dry brush it with Administratum Grey. So with dry brushing, all that you do, you need a bit of paper towel, crappy old brush, and you just put a bit of paint on the tip, get your brush, get your tissue, and literally brush all the paint off the brush. So got something similar to that, and then all you do is get the model and just rub it over all the sand, or whatever you've got on your base. So get a bit more paint, rub it all off, and then I'm just literally just dragging the brush all over the model, or all over the base, sorry, not the model. And that is the base pretty much complete. All you got to do at the end is just coat the base in, I use super glue, but I put my grass flock on later on. So that's dry brushing quickly for you. So now we need liquid talent, AGRAX Earthshade, or the old Devil and Mud, as everyone used to use, if you've got that one still. So now we need a trusty wash brush. I split it last night. Yeah, so I need to get some new ones. But anyway, right, AGRAX Earthshade. So all you do with this is literally, like we did on the Elites, you coat the entire model head to toe. Try not to get it on the base this time, because the base is pretty much complete now. So just try your best. It doesn't matter if it goes on a little bit, it gives them a bit of a footprint. But yeah, we coat the entire model in AGRAX Earthshade. So, and as you can see, as you put it on, all the details come out. So let's try and get some better light just to show this off a bit more. But that will be coming soon. So coat the entire model in it. And the last one. And that is it. So if you'd like, if you want to, you could let that dry, put your flock on or leave your base as it is, and you've got some tabletop ready models. So, but I'm going to take this a step further once these are dry, and I'll show you in a minute once it's all ready to go. So I'll let this dry and I'll be back in a minute. See you in a bit. Right, now the wash is dry, this is what you're left with. Pretty much tabletop ready models. So you could literally, as I said before, just chuck these on the table and you're ready to go. But what I like to do with these now is just use a bit of the Vallejo silver, and then all I do is get a little bit on my brush, and then you see all these little lumps and bumps in their back. I literally just have barely any paint on the brush. Just use the side of the brush and just drag it across the top. And as you can see, it just picks out all the little details, all the tops of them, like so. Now you can already see the difference there from the other two. It just brings out all the little details, and it just adds so much to the model. Same on the respirator, just drag a little bit over the nose and over the side bits, and the same on this guy. Just use the side of the brush. It's almost edge highlighting, but more of a crude version. And but you don't want too much paint on your brush, because if you have too much paint on, you end up flooding the whole thing, and you end up with just really bright silver everywhere rather than just the little highlight. So, and then these bits on the side here, I just like to put a little dab in the middle, just around the edge in the middle, just like so, just to brighten out, because the AGRAX Earthshade dulls everything right down, and it also mats all your metallics, because believe it or not, all the Games Workshop washes have a matting agent in. So they actually dull all your metallics. So I'm just running over the back bits again, just to bring them up, just putting a line across them, do the side bits again, just like that. Literally just dragging the brush all over them. I'm not painting them fully, just literally dragging the brush, just so it catches all the little details. Just like that. And it brings them right up. I really like it. So wash that out. And then I'm gonna attempt, so this is a test live on air. with the green glow on the plasma pistols and these ones, I actually did it with the airbrush, but I know a lot of people don't have airbrushes, so I'm going to try and do it without an airbrush. I don't think it'd be too difficult. So first, we want Sick Green from Vallejo Game Air, or you could use Warpstone Glow from Games Workshop. It's very, I think Warpstone Glow is actually a little bit brighter than this, but Warpstone Glow will be great. So let's give this a go. Right, so all I'm going to do now is, from the tip of the gun, I'm just going to take this color and just drag it back almost all the way to the hand, but leaving a little tiny bit of the purple showing. So, and you want to do this on all three, on both sides. So just like that. And then same on the other sides of all the weapons. Just paint about halfway down, leaving some of the purple still showing. Just like so. So already they're looking glowy. So need to let this dry and then I'll come back and then you'll need a brighter green. So I'm going to be using a Scorpia green, but you could use Moot Green from Games Workshop. Be back in a minute. All right, welcome back. While off camera as well, I also painted the rim of the base black, just because I thought while it's drying, I might as well do that. And then I can show you what I do when I flock the base as well. So all we need to do now, just to add a little bit more to the glow, is I'm using ESCORPENA green. But as I said, you can use Moot Green as well from Games Workshop. So with this lighter green, all you need to do is the middles of the guns just here is just put a little bit like that. So I'm not being terribly neat, I'm just dragging it from the tip into the middle, from the tip into the middle, and then do the same on both sides. On all three. Don't forget to do the front of the tip. And there we go. That is it. So if I hold these up here, as you can see, the green, I mean, these guys here, the green has been airbrushed. These guys here, as you've seen, I just did it with a brush. So you can get very, very similar results using a brush. But yeah, I'm just going to give that a couple of seconds just over my heater, just to dry off. But while I'm doing that, I'll grab a pot. So this is the static grass that I use. It's spring alpine grass. As I said in the other video, I've sieved this because it comes with little cork like pieces in. I sieve all the cork pieces out, so I'm just left with a nice bright static grass. And yeah, so right, they're dry. And all I do is take the lid off, use a bit of super glue because I'm impatient and I can't be bothered to wait for PVA to dry. And all I do is just pick random points, put a lump of super glue, spread it out a little bit at the front there. And I'll do another bit at the back here and a little tiny dob at the front there. So get my grass, get your fingers in there and just sprinkle it on. So then all I do is tip the excess back into the pot and then give it a bit of a blow, which stands all the grass up. And there you go. So move that out of the way. Bring these guys back in. That is it. So they're pretty rough and ready, the grunts, but there's a lot of them to paint. So you could, if you wanted to, you could go in and highlight the individual pieces on the arms and stuff, but I wouldn't bother. They're such small models that I don't think it needs it. But later on, I'm like a year or so down the line, if I'm bored, I might highlight the skin just to bring it up a bit. But yeah, nice, quick, easy tutorial, and I hope you liked it. So quickly move the paints out of the way, and also, as you can see, as I showed you on the Elites painting tutorial, how to do the blue OSL, on some of my grunts, I've done them, because in the game, they come running up to you with grenades, and they're ready to blow, and they're glowing blue. So on a couple of the bases, I've done one of them with a live grenade, so that just changes it up a little bit. I mean, if you put that, I mean, here's an element all together, and as you can see, the blue glow just changes it up a little bit. I've also got the guys with the fuel rods. Again, I did the green with the airbrush, but as I've shown, you can do it with the brush as well. So yeah, I love these guys. Some of my favorite models to paint. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed it. I hope the tutorial comes in handy. I will be doing more. Every model that you get in the starter set, I will be doing a tutorial for. I haven't painted any ghosts or warthogs as of yet, but they are base coated. The ghosts are, anyway, as you can see. So I'm going to practice on those ones, and then I will get my other box built, and I'll show you from start to finish on how to paint them. But I'm warning you now, with the ghosts, I paint mine with an airbrush just to get a nice smooth purple. And the same with the warthogs, to get a nice flat green. As you can see, this one's base coated. I base coat it with an airbrush so that it's nice and flat. But yeah, hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to like and subscribe. We've just hit 400 subscribers. And we've been going since October, so we're blown away by that. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video. I'll throw up some pictures at the end, just so you get an idea of what the army looks like together. And yeah, I'll see you next time. Happy wargaming.